Welcome back to My Carolina. I'm Joanna Heims. I'm so honored to have my husband, Wes, with me on the show today. We, like so many of you, have been stuck in a house together for a few weeks now, and I'll admit it, we're struggling. So we've brought in an expert, Dr. Kristen Wynns from Wynns Family Psychology. She's a psychologist and an author. She's here with us. She's going to help us out. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
We're not crazy, right? We're not the only people struggling being cooped up in the house together.
I am hearing this from everybody, friends, family, people I work with who are also in the field who supposedly know some stuff about how to deal with this stress. Everybody is struggling, and it's really tough on couples, no matter if you've been married 20 years or newlyweds or about to be married.
Yeah, it's the balance between the work and then making sure my five-year-old daughter does her schoolwork and then giving Joanna time to do her show from home. It's a very tiptoe balancing act.
That's really hard for a lot of couples I'm talking to who are now both working at home. And I've really been suggesting it's helpful to have an end of day kind of ritual to say the workday is done. Now it's time for family time and couple time, but some official distinction that, okay, work is done, laptops are closed, phones are put up, and now it's time for connection. So whatever that might be for your family, just to kind of have it be a consistent kind of end of day ritual is helpful. So what about you, Joanna? What's the hardest part for you with being cooped up during these tough quarantine times?
Oh, it's heaven here. I mean, for me, it's definitely a little bit of a personal space issue. I have a five-year-old and an almost two-year-old and a husband, and they all just want a piece of mom all the time. And it's kind of hard to have an office, not to have an office to escape to.
Right. I think that's especially hard if you do have little ones who still want to be on top of you. I'm at the other end with my teenagers where I have to hunt them down and beg them to come and sit by me. But again, if you have little ones around and you have a two-parent home, I'm a big fan of, you know, tag team. Hey, the kids have been all over me for the last 2 hours. Can you take around? And that's when you can go off, Joanna, and take a bath or paint your nails. To be intentional about, okay, now is my time with the kids. I'm going to keep them away from you to let you have space. Okay, now it's your turn. I think that's helpful. And again, thank goodness we've got spring here in North Carolina to get outside. So if you're just completely feeling overwhelmed by the on top of each other nature of being inside, just to have somebody go outside and take a walk. But I also think it's a great time to practice don't sweat the small stuff. And I know a lot of people are kind of laughing that they never knew their spouse chewed that way or breathed that way before. Or how can you possibly wear those same shorts 4 days in a row? But now, if there's ever a time to let go of the small stuff and look at big picture, hey, we're in this together. We've got this. And now's the time for that big picture mentality.
Absolutely. And so I know one of our struggles has also always been date night, but now it's kind of having date night at home and making it feel like a date.
Yeah, it's hard because you can't really go outside or leave. And then we have two children. So once they go to bed, it's like we have to try to make time at the end of the day for just me and her.
I definitely think now's the time to get creative with date time. So if you've got little kids, put them to bed and have a second dinner or a later dinner, just the two of you. It's also been fun for us to do double dates virtual with some of our close friends.
We love all of those ideas, and we're gonna have to try some of them out. So thank you for all the advice, guys. If you missed any of that, check out mycarolina.tv. You can check out a link to her website as well.